Hey everyone, I'm Rathangu here. I just finished the Scarlet Keys playthrough on the channel. Zoey was my main fighter protecting a Cleaver Charlie Kane, whose review I've already posted. And you already know what I'm about to say. Zoey Samaras is a good character. She's a great fighter, not one of the best, but nowhere near one of the worst. She's somewhere in the upper middle of the pack of characters. 4-2-4-2 as a stat line, like, it's not what you want to see. You want to see a 1 somewhere to more efficiently get stats elsewhere. You'd really like to see a 5, even though you aren't really expecting that because 5s are a bit busted. 2 foot, 1 foot, there's not really a difference, you're failing that test. 2 book, you're a main fighter at that point, it's fine. Theoretically, with 4 head and Dunwich Slash, you can try to do cute shit where you use Rite of Seekings and 6 Sense and you do Flex Kluver, but that build is so expensive with so many assets. But I think the best way, and really only good way, to build Zoey Samaras is to just build her as your pure fighter. And to that end, what do you use those Flex cards for? Well, Down the Rabbit Hole taught me that Guardian decks are just as boring as Mystic decks. Sure, you can build a lot of different Guardian decks, that's true, but then you upgrade them and your weapons get better and your allies get better, so you upgrade Safeguard and your skills and Stand Together, and oh my god, it just works. Down the Rabbit Hole just works in Guardian decks at pretty much full value. Aside from this one copy of Fang of Tearthrow that I replaced my Refine with, stick to the plan and Charismas, I just got max value from Down the Rabbit Hole. It's a very good card in Zoey. As for the other 4, Spectral Razor is at its absolute best in Zoey. There are a few characters that use it comparably to her, but no one that uses it better than her. And Deep Knowledge is just a wonderful card to throw in literally anyone that has access to it. The only real fear you have as this deck is that somehow you miss your weapons. With a couple of fighting events and 4 weapons and a prepared for the worst under your stick to the plan, you can pretty reliably just run Deep Knowledge on the assumption that if you've somehow missed your weapon, this will give you the consistency to find your weapon, instead of running 5th and 6th terrible backup weapons. Like, you could run machetes instead of this, but you'd much rather have the more generally useful Deep Knowledge card instead. And for the record, I think this is more than consistent enough. In my entire playthrough of Scarlet Keys, I did not even once use Prepared for the Worst. Every single game, I managed to find weapons without even using the Prepared for the Worst I have under my stick to the plan. Every single scenario after I got sick of the plan, it was turn 1 emergency cash. There were a couple of times where it wasn't turn 2 ever vigilant, usually because something was getting in the way or because I was trying to maximize value and being greedy, but like, usually it's turn 2 ever vigilant, get out a weapon. I've never had to use Prepare for the Worst in that entire campaign. So the consistency is just there. Deep Knowledge is upgraded Stand Togethers, which I got fairly early. I think most people wait too long to buy this. It's an incredible card. You should be buying it relatively quickly. Especially in two-handed like I was playing. Like, in two-player, this is just one of the best cards in the game. It's Deep Knowledge, except it draws another card and gives you 4 resources and also doesn't put curses in the bag. So yeah, it's a pretty damn good card. As for the rest of the Zoey deck, beyond just like the consistency of these splash cards and the injection of experience you get, I do want to talk about Runic Axis. I think they're incredible. If you have the Saga upgrade, it only runs out of charges if you get the other upgrade. What's it called? Ancient Power, that allows you to burn charges to get plus damage over and over and over again. I don't think you should do that, although I am aware there could be a cute thing where you get Ancient Power and you use Bandolier to hold a Runic Axe in each hand. So like, there is actually a Nordic Berserker thing you can do that's not entirely a meme, but you're just better off using the Bandolier to hold Survival Knives and getting a more generically useful Runic Axe, I feel. Runic Axe with just 3 experience gets Saga, you get 2 charges a turn instead of 1, and at that point the axe doesn't run out of charges anymore. To run out of charges on the Runic Axe, if you get 2 at the start of your turn, you start at 4, swing 3 times in 1 turn, that's the most you can get. Alright, cool, you're down to 1, you get 2 charges back from Saga, 3 times in 1 turn, you're down to 0, you got all 3 swings though, 2 charges back at the start of the turn, and then on the 3rd turn of 3 consecutive attack actions, you finally run out of charges on the 9th attack. So like, that's just not a real concern. Mix in some fight events. Like, every other ammo-based weapon in the game is also not shooting for 9 rounds straight. When you run Flamethrower, you run extra ammo, so run some fighting events. Get some Sweeping Kick, some Spectral Razor. Something to take pressure off of this. That's the same reason I ran Bandolier Survival Knives. It's because if I'm ever in a situation where I need to swing consecutively turn after turn, Survival Knives will give me a lot of additional action compression and help to mitigate the one and only weakness of Runic Axe. Because once you have Script Weaver and Saga, twice a turn you're swinging at +3 to hit for 2 damage, and you can also mix it up and use additional inscriptions You can heal a damage or a horror or draw a card on a kill. You can move or engage before you attack with Inscription of the Hunt, which I 100% forgot at some point during one of the scenarios and would have been helpful to remember. But yeah, Runic Axe just, it does its job. It's not Cyclopean Hammer's level of strong, but it is very, very strong. And the only real weakness it has can be mitigated in the form of events and Survival Knife Bandolier strats, or Beat Cops, or a million other things. But in particular, the one thing I want to emphasize with this deck is it has the best level 1 fighter upgrade I've ever seen. I took In the Thick of It and banked experience. I just got Ever Vigilant and nothing else because I knew Ever Vigilant would cost me money from down the rabbit hole later, or experience rather. And my plan was to bank experience and try to get stick to the plan and down the rabbit hole. It didn't work first scenario, and I was going Marrakesh first scenario, so I needed to just get an upgrade to be better at fighting. And what I ended up doing is I realized that this deck has the best upgrade for scenario 2 I've ever seen in a fighter. You presumably play Refine in your first scenario. I don't have it. I've replaced it with Fang at this point. But you play Refine for a free experience on your Runic Axe. Then you use Down the Rabbit Hole twice to upgrade your Survival Knives. And then you use 2 experience to get Saga after the Refine. So for 4 experience, you get essentially 4 upgraded weapons into your deck. And at that point, I really do feel like you're the strongest scenario 2 fighter in the game. Because other people might have better card pools or better stat lines, but no one else gets an upgrade this efficient off of just 4 experience. So that's pretty much it for this video. She fights, she has good head, and she makes good use of Spectral Razor and Guts in a way most people don't. She has a boring Guardian deck, so she uses Down the Rabbit Hole well. Runic Axe fits nicely in. I don't think it's one of those S-tier weapons. My S-tier of weapons is Flamethrower, Machete, Cyclopean Hammer, and Survival Knife. Machete is obviously there for very different reasons. I think Cyclopean Hammer and Flamethrower are the best obviously good weapons, but the unparalleled action compression you get out of Survival Knife, engage and turn, they're dead. That is something that I think allows them to catch up as long as you have a way to reliably get out a Bandolier and some other stuff so that your turns don't suck. And while Runic Axe isn't quite as good as those S-tier weapons, I do think it's an A-tier weapon, and I think it pairs perfectly with Survival Knives. Because the only weakness it has, no real action compression, a limit to the maximum number of consecutive attacks, Survival Knife neatly fixes those issues. Anyways, that's it for Zoey. Good character, good build, Down the Rabbit Hole still gross, Deep Knowledge still gross, doing gross things. I'm gonna rather go here to hope you enjoyed this very brief overview of Zoey. She's a good character, always has been, always will be, slowly getting better with the card pool though. Anyways, if you did like the video, like, comment, subscribe, all that nonsense really does help the channel grow, and I'll see you in the next one.